and whether the group of eight, the UN and the US and the world community, in addition with the Arab League, are considering an alternative sanction or an alternative military action instead of the no-fly zone. And we're delighted to have with us Mr. Mohammed Al-Alfi, the economic and political analyst with us. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
First of all, let's start off with France. France officially earlier recognized the Libyan Opposition Council, in addition with other EU countries, considering the this council as a partner for talks. So do you see that recognition as a sign of an escalation of maybe more stiff action towards what's happening in Libya and the dictatorship regime?
Today what happened in the Security Council is, and also the talk between the Security Council and the G8, it's supporting the massacre in Libya. Today they said no-fly zone will not serve the situation. And they said also the military intervention is refused by Libyans and the Arabs. Okay, what is the solution? Now they are giving a chance to Gaddafi to kill more and to commit more crimes against his people. Today, since last night until today the afternoon, the Gaddafi air forces is hitting Agdabia and Breka and Zawawa, and it's impossible to believe that has happened.
And he's retaining them back. But yeah. how about a solution like maybe enforcing a ban over the arms trading, considering the areas where Gaddafi is getting the arms from, like South Africa, for example, like Venezuela. I mean, monitoring the arms trading in that areas and trying to stop the arms into getting into the Libyan territory.
Last Friday, there is a huge vessel raising the Greek flag, carrying military equipment to Gaddafi last Friday. And until now, no reinforcement for the rebels. What does that mean? That means they are given a talk. We are against Muammar Gaddafi, and they are not supporting the rebels. That means they are not giving the truth. They are ashamed from something, from hidden data. Maybe that is all this information or data that they are afraid Gaddafi will announce about it. And the Gaddafi son said, we will announce in the suitable time the hidden and the secrets for the bribes for most of the senior men in this world.
Right. Another important question that raises itself, why the United States and the UN Security Council are not taking the same stance and the same reaction they took back with the Gaza war in 2009, I guess, when they completely banned the reinforcement of arms to the Palestinians during the war. They completely refused to allow any enforcement of or enforcing of arms to the people inside Palestine.
The people inside Palestine, they don't have oil and they don't have money. Mm-hmm. They need aid all times, so no one will
this could be a tangible solution.
Yeah. No one will be care if they will die or they will live. They only support Israel, if right or wrong. But the situation, returning back to situation in Libya is very dangerous. And now, if they will not reinforce the rebels, now they are going to divide Libya to the east and west. And that is.
And what could be the implications of such a division?
Now, if you will just take a fast look at the situation on the ground, Gaddafi is trying, as his talk, to liberate the ports exporting oil from the rebels. Now he's concentrating only to take all these places because
the oil exists.
Yes, because the goal is oil. The game is oil. If he control oil, that means he can play against them.
Yeah, but this shows a sign of retreating, because I guess this shows that he is retreating. He's accepting their existence in some parts of Libya. I mean, is giving up some of the parts except for the places where the oil is there, then he's not going to give up.
The G8, G20, Security Council, European communities, they are not serious. Now, as we know, there is 2 years or 3 years the U.S. Elections, presidential elections, and 2012 the French elections. Barack Obama especially and Nicolas Sarkozy, they are trying to play this game to get a new gains to support themselves in the second period to go to the presidency chair for the second time. But I think Barack Obama is afraid because he's under pressure of the Congress, American Congress. They are afraid from to lose many things like what happened in Iraq. But Nicolas Sarkozy here also in a bad situation because of the financial crisis is still the affection of the financial crisis is still as it is. And the solution for most of the European community and for the United States in the Middle East, not outside the Middle East. But until now, they are still delaying the action to see what political and economical gains can get for themselves or for the to save the luxury life for them citizens. But here, no one talk about the human rights in Libya. No one talk about the crimes, the daily crimes done by Gaddafi forces, because now we believe that the life of the Arabian people is very cheap, and the human rights, the talk of the human rights is, and the issues of the human rights, it's only in Europe and the States, and now it's a message to the rebels to rely on themselves. And unfortunately, the last statement by Secretary General Amr Moussa for the Arabian League is showing the weakness of this Arab nations. Really, I'm ashamed from this statement. It's sending the ball to the playground of the Security Council, and today Security Council returning back the ball to the Arab League to say to them.
Well, people are falling martyrs.
Yes, he said the Arab League
on the battlefield.
Yeah, the Arab League is. Should carry the responsibility, and they should announce clearly they are ready to share more than what they are expecting. I mean, the statement by Security Council is not clear about the about which points they will share, but I think they will ask them if there is a military intervention to share as Arabian forces or to carry the responsibility of the cost of the no-fly zone, because no-fly zone from day one to 6 months, it will cost between $3 billion US dollars to $8 billion US dollars. And they said, Security Council and the G8 and G20 and the United States said, we will not, you are not ready to spend to carry this amount.
They've already spent a lot in the during the Iraqi war.
Yes, they are saving the oil for the next 50 years. That is the new strategy of the United States. Because as you know, they also, and we should know, explain this point to our viewers, the old strategy in the last 50 years to replace, to end occupation and to replace it by dictators. Because the dictators serving these countries more rather than the occupation. The occupation is costing them too much money and lives of them soldiers. But the dictator is also bringing the. They are here for the resources
for and the same mission.
For the same mission, also dictator is bringing the Western companies to extract the resources and then send it to them, and the money of these
to
resources,
set us out of our
yeah,
wealth.
Money of these resources in them banks, and also the stolen money by dictator in them banks, and nothing will be back to the to us again.
Right. Earlier, the French president, I guess, Nicolas Sarkozy, vowed to exchange ambassadors with this interim governing council in Libya, the new one. Yet this decision was not really welcomed by the rest of the European countries. So do you see that division weakening the G8 stance and in the course of trying to come or unify all their fronts on only one decision concerning what's happening in Libya?
First of all, there is no one voice for the European community. And we'll go to second point to Nicolas Sarkozy. Nicolas Sarkozy is introducing himself to the world as a sole leader in Europe. And he takes this action to open a new consulate in Benghazi, in rebels area, to try to has taken a fast action to try to get more economical gains. When the rebels will control Libya, they will look, they will thinking, and they will look who support us. And from the first moment, they will say, "France, okay, we are going to cooperate with France." It's a huge business in Libya. So he would like, he's expecting from this action to get more gains, more economical gains later, and the, of course, this economical gains will affect. And on his situation in the next election in 2012.
If we look at Italy and its reaction towards what's happening in interviews published on Saturday, Gaddafi's son Saif al-Islam said that he talked about France, the recognition of the rebels in eastern Benghazi, as and also as on Italy, he said, as true representatives. He said this was bizarre from France, and also he blasted out it. He fired back at Italy, accusing it of treason, and he was threatening economic retaliation. So do we read that as an absolute and once and for all termination of the long time relationship between Libya and Italy? How will that lead Libya and Italy to?
If you will talk about the Libyan, the Italian Prime Minister, this man is, as all knows, that is the man of the mafia man in this chair. He's not the Prime Minister, real Prime Minister of Libya, and he's ready to play all games to get money. And I think now. He went to before to do a sharing business with Gaddafi and his sons. It's a private business, and that is what Gaddafi's son, Saif al-Islam Gaddafi, said. We will announce soon if they will not change the situation against Libya, and also the investment in Libya, the Libyan investment in Italy. It's also a huge investment, and he said that's a treason from the European community when Saif al-Islam Gaddafi said that, because from 2006 until now, Libya invests $70 billion in the European projects. So they think that is the European voices will not be against them. That is the situation right now. But as we know, this is a bad situation for Berlusconi in Italy right now, and he's ready to not to betray Gaddafi, to betray himself to be saved or to success.
Right. With the Arab League entering the scene with its statements, and then they were also considering some military action.